Next up in my Best of 2019 series is a request from Patreon supporter Billy for the biggest surprises of 2019. In no particular order, let's kick this off with Shia LaBeouf being a standout in two exceptional films. I am not really into celebrity gossip, but I'm also not unaware of what Shia LaBeouf has been through over the years, so there's that, and also the fact that while I do think he delivers quality work in everything I've seen him in, none of his more recent films have really won me over quite like Honey Boy and the Peanut Butter Falcon did this year. To think that Shia LaBeouf is one of my favorite actors of 2019, I just didn't expect to be saying that so enthusiastically right now. Peanut Butter Falcon is just such a joy to watch, and LaBeouf's chemistry with Zach Gottsagen is a delight, one of my favorite on-screen friendships of the year, no doubt. And with Honey Boy, his performance in it is just so raw, and he also wrote an excellent screenplay for it with a really unique structure to it that I think winds up making the whole story even more powerful. Moving on here now, we're going to the movie Hustlers. So Hustlers did just miss out on my top 10, but it is very close. I did have a good feeling about the movie after seeing that first trailer, but I didn't expect it to be this good, let alone a real possible Oscar contender. The movie is loaded with excellent performances, which of course includes Jennifer Lopez. Laureen Scafaria really knocked it out of the park, making the film super stylish, energetic, and fun to watch, but never at the expense of the dark reality of the situation. And this is another one where I just loved how the script was structured. It kind of plays a little like the article reads, and coming at the events from that particular perspective really adds a very interesting and highly engaging layer to the whole experience that I think contributes to making Hustlers a standout. Next up here, I've got Downton Abbey. Again, not in my top 10, but it was pretty high up on my list, higher than I would ever have expected it to be, especially as a non-Downton Abbey series fan. Period costume dramas just aren't usually my thing, and I've always made the assumption that I wouldn't like Downton Abbey the series. This year, though, I wound up in a situation where I did have to do a little homework in order to prepare to cover the release of the movie. So I started watching season one of the show and just blew through it. I started that binge a little too late, so I didn't have time to go beyond that before actually seeing the feature film, but it didn't really matter. I thoroughly enjoyed the movie so much. Simply put, it made me happy. The charm of those characters is infectious, and so is their chemistry as one big family unit. Seeing them come together and have their moment during the King and Queen's visit, I was kind of overjoyed for them. Next up here is what I'm dubbing the Year of Neon. Neon has had some really great success ever since launching in 2017. I, Tonya was one of their movies. They also had Colossal, Three Identical Strangers, Vox Lux, and more, but I think their 2019 slate might be their best yet. Wild Rose, Luce, Apollo 11, Monos, Little Monsters, Parasite, Portrait of a Lady on Fire, Clemency. You can't look at that list of movies and not think that Neon is one of the strongest players out there right now. They've got some serious awards contenders in the mix this year and high quality of work all over the place. But one of the things that I admire most about Neon films is that they're so different. So, is it a surprise that Neon is finding more success in 2019? No, not exactly, but I look at their lineup and I see it as a real giant leap for the company, well beyond what I might have predicted. Hands down, one of my favorite distributors of the year, and I couldn't be happier for them. Finally, we are wrapping up this list with Escape Room, because Escape Room easily could have wound up being a cash grab. Escape rooms are super hot right now, so let's put a horror spin on it and make a quick buck. It is that, in a sense, a really cool current high concept, and who can blame a company for wanting to churn out a movie like that? But it's also so much more. It ticks all the boxes you'd want in a fun, horror, pick-em-off, one-by-one kind of thrill, but it goes well beyond that, too, thanks to great performances from the lead ensemble, and also so many expertly crafted set pieces from director Adam Robitel and his crew. The attention to detail, the building of suspense, how different each escape room is. It doesn't just work, it works exceptionally well. The concept here certainly warrants a franchise, and I've got a whole lot of faith that Robitel is going to make the most of that upcoming second go around. If you've been looking at Escape Room as a January release loaded with cheap scares, trust me, give it a go. I'd like to bet you won't be disappointed. So that's it. That's a wrap on this list. Another big thanks to Billy for suggesting it. If you check out any of the movies, any of the work from any of the individuals or companies I just mentioned, do tell me about it in the comment section below. A big thanks to all of you for watching this best of 2019 content. This isn't my last video of 2019 because I have a Q&A looking back at the entire decade coming your way so soon. So keep an eye out for that. Bye, guys. Bye, guys. Bye, guys.